friends, it's Sudhya from Backyard Garden Highlights, Hillsborough, New Jersey, Zone 6B. Hope you guys are doing great today. Today I'm planning to fertilize my shrubs and plants. I thought I would share it with you guys how I'm doing that. I'm planning to use Aspama organic fertilizer. So most likely I'm going to use only Plantone today. Let me show you guys some of the basic things when you look for fertilizers. When you go to garden center, you will see all these different kinds of fertilizers with the different numbers, combinations. Basically, the numbers denotes what's the NPK rate. So when you see the packet, it will have three different numbers. Each number represents one of the nutrients needed for the plants. Basically, it is called as NPK rate. For example, here, if you see Aspama organic Plantone 533, that means the NPK rate is 533. N refers to nitrogen, P refers to phosphorus, and K refers to potassium. All these three nutrients are basic necessary for any plants. Nitrogen is most required for any plant to grow bushy and greeny, and then phosphorus helps the plant to establish nice strong root growth, and then K refers to potassium, that kind of helps immune system for the plant, so it provides all the necessary nutrients to protect the plants from disease and fight against any problems that the plant may face. In general, I am planning to use Aspama all-purpose Plantone. We tend to think that, okay, when you see a packet of 8-10-10 or 10-10-10, we feel that, okay, this has more amount of nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. Should I go with that one or should I stick with the smaller number, whatever 5-4-4 or 5-3-3, something like that. I'm not an expert, but based on my understanding, it is not really needed because the plant can consume so much of quantity of each nutrients from what we are supplying. So even if you are supplying more, they will not be able to consume all that quantity. So it's kind of waste of your money and it's kind of unnecessary to put so much into your soil, right? So I'm going to stick with 5-3-3 today. Doing this at least once a year, especially when the spring starts, that's really going to be helpful. Let's go and see how I'm applying them. I'm going to start fertilizing from this flower bed. In the packet, you will see fertilizer needs to be applied around the drip line of the plant. If the bush has grown this much, so the entire plant, the growth, that's the radius you need to apply the fertilizer. So that's a concept I also learned when I started applying fertilizers. When you apply the fertilizers, you need to apply them around the drip line of the plant, not near the crown or not near the trunk actually. It's good to apply them during the evening or morning time, and after you fertilize, you need to water them thoroughly so that they can be consumed by the plant. So if you have 3 to 4 inches of mulch, then it is recommended you kind of remove the mulches and then apply the fertilizer so that the plant can get it sooner or later. These are my onion and garlic batches. Alright guys, that's it for today. Hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. See you in the next video.